Hey, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Gavinsky's Tutorials. Today, I'm going to do a walkthrough, demo, and review of Quantum Filter by GS DSP. So this is a really nice modulated filter app. I'm looking at it here at the iPad version, but it's also available for iPhone and on desktop for Windows and Mac. So modulated filtering, and this is part of this Quantum series that GS DSP have, Quantum Delay, Quantum Distortion, and so on. All of these apps have a very similar modulation system, and that is where all of the power is, really. I have a very detailed walkthrough on my Patreon of how the modulation system in this works. It'll really help you understand these apps if you're not familiar with how to set up the modulation. So let's look at what's happening here. I'm going to bring this one in as well. Lovely, huh? So if we look at this instance, here we can see that we have two filters. Here we see the routing. So in this case, these are in parallel routing. Now, if we flick over to this other one, here we can see the routing is serial. When you're in serial mode, you can have up to three filters. When you're in parallel mode, you can have up to two filters. In parallel mode, you'll see over here these levels for each of the filters, separate levels. Now, we have various types that we can choose. So here we have the first one, a bandpass filter. Here we can see that this is set to dual mono. So separate frequency and resonance for the left and right, and separate gain for the filter for each one. Here, this is not separate, this is just stereo, it's not dual mono. You just have one frequency knob and one resonance knob. There's no separate left and right. Note here that you have a little power button which can turn each filter off. So for example, here, this one is turned off. Now here we can click through various types. We're not listening to them as this one is turned off, I'm just showing you what's there. So there are four different ladder types based on the number of poles. Over here we have a dry wet knob, you can lock it. You have knobs to control input, wet, and output levels. You have stuff up here, you know, you can randomize, like do mild randomization, medium, or very strong randomization. You have undo and redo. You've got a preset system, which I'm really not that crazy about. I don't really like how it's done. But it does have batch import and export of presets, which is very useful on iOS, given that the presets are sandboxed. You can do A-B comparison. You press this button here, then anytime you touch something, you'll get some help popping up. And you can choose different languages as well for those tooltips, really tons of different languages. You can also turn on a limiter and stuff here. You can lock various things, not just the dry and wet. So let's just listen to a couple of other examples. So look, there are some really good factory presets and some really good sound designer presets. So you have presets by Christian Vogel, Data Broth, Zanshin, and they really are very good. So this one, add a shaker to your beat. Yeah, that's what that's like with that on, and that's it off. Okay, here's one by Data Broth, Bricks. Really cool. So of course you can also use these on other stuff. Thank you. So if we see here, we have a Bell filter and a high shelf filter, and you can see those being modulated here. Now, if we turn on this button in the modulation section, that will show us the mapping. So here we can see that this is a random type of modulator, and it is modulating the frequency and resonance of the high shelf. And we can just, you know, increase or decrease these. We have, power button, which can just turn this off. We can make it unipolar or bipolar. We can sample and hold, so basically just freeze it at the position it's at the moment. This is where we choose other different modulator types. And this I will not go into in detail in this video. Like I say, I've got a great video on that on Patreon. Here you can just get rid of this modulation source. You can switch between, you know, quantized times, and you have loads of different types and divisions, and free time in hertz. Here you can choose with randomization things whether it will jump to a value or glide smoothly between values and stuff like that. So again, if we click on this and click through these, then we can see, you know, this is modulating that frequency of that low shelf filter, and so on and so on. Here you can turn everything on and off. Here you can adjust the amount, well, scale the amounts for all of them. And here you can do a global sample and hold. Over here you can adjust this level of the parameter that is being controlled, and here you adjust the range. So just flick through a few different examples. So if we look at the types, it is really very powerful. There are a lot of options. So you can have envelopes, ADSR or attack and release envelope. When you go into these modes, you can send MIDI in and use that MIDI basically to do kind of gating effects and stuff like that. Again, I go into this in more detail in my Patreon video. Now, I really love the followers. So you have not only the more standard amplitude follower, but you can also follow pitch and all these other things. It's really pretty great. You have a bunch of different 2D LFOs. Basically, what they will let you do is map separate X and Y axis parameters. That can be really interesting. So for example, here, when we see this circle moving around, when it's moving vertically, it's going to be increasing whatever we've set up mapped to the y-axis. And when it's moving over in this direction, then it's going to be, you know, adjusting the x-axis. What else do we have? Okay, so 2D random. Just various types of random modulators. Some dynamical systems like a double pendulum and stuff like that. That's basically a pendulum with another pendulum attached to it. 3D motion. So, for example, very handy on the iPad or iPhone. Use the acceleration, orientation, or rotation of your device to modulate parameters. And here you can just have a macro knob or an XY pad. So really, really powerful in the modulation system. And GS DSP have an app called MMM, which is totally free to download, and which has all of this, all of these modulation options. You can use them to send MIDI to control any parameters of any app. But I'll just mention quickly, you know, you might think, well, okay, if I have MMM, for example, which is free, why don't I just take that and modulate, you know, different filters, right? And you can do that, but the thing you need to bear in mind is that when you're working with MIDI, you're only going to have, you know, those values from 0 to 127. So when you are adjusting a parameter that has like frequencies, for example, filter frequencies or oscillator frequencies and stuff like that, if you are using a MIDI LFO, you will get stepping and it just won't sound that great. Whereas when you're using the modulation built into an app the way it is here, then you will get completely smooth frequency changes. So this is the problem. It's a huge problem really with using MIDI to control anything frequency based. So if we see here, we got a couple of random modulators. Here we can choose, you know, we can immediately just switch it to being the stepped or to step type or the type that moves smoothly. And here LFO, you want to change the type, just go in here and choose something else. On to the next example. So again, remember that, remember that controls like these are not global, okay? This is just for this modulator. But these can be really fun to play around with. And when you're playing with those, I would recommend playing around also with unipolar and bipolar. Right? These apps have the most powerful built-in modulation systems that I know of. If you know of any other apps that have great inbuilt modulation, let us know in the comments. I really love those kind of apps. So you can see there, you know, this is for filter one frequency. This, for example, is filter two resonance. Let's go on to the next example. Dry wet knob. Okay, everyone, so I hope this was useful for you. If it was, please smash the like and write a comment. And remember, everyone, if you're ever buying desktop apps, it'll really help me out if you use the plugin boutique link that I post in the pinned comment here. It will get me a little bit of a cut. It won't cost you anything and stuff like that. And Patreon support is really genuinely crucial for me to be able to keep on doing this channel. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers, folks. Take it easy.